Okay, hello everyone. Now in this video we are going to discuss about the reproduction in fungi. So generally there are three types of reproduction in fungi, that is vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual type of reproduction. First we will concentrate on vegetative reproduction. In this type of reproduction, the formation of new thallus take place from vegetative part. It does not involve the formation of spore. The following methods of vegetative reproduction are known in fungi. First one, fragmentation. Here the mycelium or hyphae break up into a number of small fragments which are capable of developing into new mycelium under favorable conditions. Such type of reproduction we can see in fungi like Aspergillus and Rhizopus. Fragmentation is a Latin word which means to break. The next type of vegetative reproduction is fission. Here in fission, simple splitting of cell into two daughter cells by a construction and formation of the cell wall occur. Such type of reproduction is commonly seen in yeast. See, so vegetative reproduction by fission. Here in second diagram, the reproduction in fungi which occur by budding. Fine. Now in next video we are going to see about the budding. Budding, it is the formation of small outgrowth, that is bud, from a parent cell wall which breaks up to form a new individual. Such type of reproduction is occurred in a fungi like Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Sometimes the bud remains attached to the mother cell and it may produce further additional bud. This process is repeated several times and results in the formation of branched or unbranched chain of cells which give the appearance of a short hypha, and it is termed as a pseudomycelium, as we already seen in figure 14c. This one, see here. That cell la punna bud ani bud varti punna bud aale, jasa branching structure represent kele jata ki aapnala disto. Tyala pseudomycelium asa matlo jato. Next type of vegetative reproduction is oidium. Here, when grown in nutrient medium, when the fungi are grown in the nutrient medium, the hypha of some fungi undergo segmentation and form rounded or thin walled cell called oidium. It's a Greek word oidion, which means small egg. Under favorable condition, each oidium on germination produce a new mycelium, for example mucor. It is also called as a arthrospore. It's a Greek word, arthro means joint and sporus means seed or spore. It may also behave as a spermatium. See, this is a diagram of oidium. Next vegetative reproduction is chlamydospores. Especially this type of reproduction occur in unfavorable condition. So some hypal cell or portions of hypha contract, lose its water, round up and become round and become surrounded by a thick wall. These are the resting bodies capable of withdrawing long unfavorable condition. Chlamydospores are formed in a fungi like Fusarium, Ustilago, etc. The next type of vegetative reproduction is sclerotia. Here, these are hard, compact mass of dominant interwoven hyphae. The external hyphae develop hard coat or rind protection the inner region from desiccation. These are the resting body formed by the fungus to pass out the unfavorable condition. Thus, these are more a means of keeping the fungus alive than of propagation. For example, claviceps. The next type of vegetative reproduction, that is formation of rhizomorph. The rhizomorph mostly develop underground with hyphae very loosely interwoven. The rhizomorph resist unfavorable conditions and remains dormant till unfavorable condition come again. Such type of formation occurs in agaricus. So, chlamydospore, rhizomorph and sclerotia, these three type of reproductive structure is formed in fungus, especially in an unfavorable condition. While oidium and budding generally occur in a favorable condition. Fine. So these are the few vegetative reproduction forms that we discuss. Now in next video we are going to discuss about the asexual type of reproduction.